meant no way. You got it. They wasn't going anyway.
Now, you sure you could get them to do it? They wouldn't do it for me.
Don't worry, I'll have them. They're my exclusive management.
Well, they're going on in a few minutes.
They're going in a few minutes, if. They're going on a 10-week tour.
How much?
$400 a week.
What?
How do you think you pay for it?
Okay, 10 weeks. But it's just 10 weeks.
And here it is. The absolute honest result of our talent contest, as read on the applause meter by Miss Edna Burke. The winner is Tiny Joe Dixon!
Yeah.
You are amazing. Marty, it ain't working, man. When I faint, I used to kill him.
You used to kill him, didn't you?
I had him laying in the aisles, baby.
Yes, you did.
But too many other people doing it now.
Yeah, Jimmy, everybody's doing it now, but I was the first.
But you know that, don't you?
Yeah, you were the first and you're still
yeah,
the first.
Yeah.
I mean, man, you killed it out there tonight. It was beautiful.
You know what, Marty, you were full of shit.
You are full of shit, man. I told you I need new material.
Jimmy, I want you to meet this young man.
Clarence Conrad Wright. I'm the writer for the Dreamettes.
Oh, yeah, you're the one that, wrote that little song the little girl said it was like,
you better move.
You wrote that one, huh?
Totally alone with absolutely no help from anyone.
Okay, Marty, what you do?
Well, I was listening to it. I just thought it was kind of
boring.
Yeah, it was real boring.
Yeah.
Well, I'm no kid, mister.
This here's a very talented composer.
Yeah, you're probably right, but this song, it just didn't have enough sound. You know what I mean, brother? See, look, I'm Jimmy. I gotta have soul.
Gotta have soul!
Look, this man can write anything. There's gotta be a way to bring soul music to a broader audience. Now, I don't understand the technical part of music, but I understand concepts, and it's all concept. The American concept of success is represented by a three-letter word known to every child. Big! As in large, as in huge, as in mine is better than yours. Now once upon a time, the Cadillac car represented the highest classes in America. The pure, unstained water. They never worried about the cost. No. Then the Cadillac car was bought by the prostitutes to prove they too were as good and hard to ski. Now we got the Cadillac.
Got me a Cadillac. James Gunn the Earth, and the Dream X, CC White, composer. We're ready, Jimmy.
Alright, just a second, man. Y'all doing alright?
Alright, baby. Catalog, Cadillac Park, take one.
Hey.
Bob Quinby. He said he'd tell me something today. But we gotta change his style a little bit. His look, he needs to style that
way. Go down better with the white on.
That would put him where he should be. Making the kind of money he should be making in clubs like the Atlantic in Miami.
You are really drifting out there, chump. Sammy Davis can't even get in there. I mean, that place is so white, they won't even let our boys park the cars.
He's on the pop track now. He's hot. Look, we could do it for him. We could do it.
We ain't got to do nothing. Jimmy's mine. So back off, Curtis. You want to change the world, go do it with your girls.
Oh, I will. I will, baby. I got big plans for them. Operator, this is Mr. Curtis Taylor Jr., room 1730. Can you give me Mr. Robert Klinger at the Atlantic Hotel in Miami, please?
Oh, Curtis, you are so gorgeously determined. You have such determination in your eyes. Have I ever told you how much I like your eyes?
Yes, Mr. Klinger. This is Curtis Taylor Jr., Jimmy Hurley's manager.
Manager? Since when?
When we spoke last week regarding the Christmas light, you said you weren't sure of Victor Moore's availability. Can you tell me something today?
Curtis! When I like a man's eyes, it's very serious, it's so serious. When I like a man's eyes,
we'll talk about my eyes when we're alone.
just know something's going on.
Did you hear what I said, Dina? I said I'm a woman now.
Laurel, I know.
What do you mean you know? Has Jimmy talked?
He didn't have to. How could you, Laurel? You're just a baby.
I am not, Tina. I'm a woman now. I'm 18, so I'm a woman.
Yeah, she's a mature woman like me. And she loves Jimmy just as much as I love Curtis. Ain't nothing wrong with loving someone. It's wonderful.
Is that all you two can think about?
There's no doubt my mama brought me up better.
Dina, you're just jealous.
Yeah, let yourself go, girl. Just once. It's so wonderful to have somebody to love.
Oh, Dina, it is. Like, after this gig is over, Jimmy and I are gonna take a little vacation.
You can. I heard Curtis got Jimmy the Americana in New York, and we're going there immediately.
No, I heard Jimmy was going to New York, and we're going to Cleveland.
Well, I ain't heard nothing.
He's in the car and he's starving.
Curtis, what is this about us going to Cleveland?
Well, I'm breaking you and Jimmy up.
I knew it. I knew you were breaking me and Jimmy up because you never liked me and Jimmy being together. Now you did because you're all jealous of me and Jimmy. Well, nothing's going to break us up. Nothing.
I'm breaking you up because the Dreamettes are going to Cleveland with their own act.
I'm not. Our own act?
Did you say our own act?
Oh,
finally, our own act. This is what I've been waiting for. I love you, Curtis.
Well, honey, my bags are packed. I love me some Jimmy, but I don't want to sing behind him for the rest of my life.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the dream.
Ooh, I like that.
Dream is for little girls. You're a woman now.
See, Dina? I told you.
You're going to have everything. I got you a record deal. New gowns, long, beautiful gowns, and new wigs, too. The most expensive. We open in Cleveland in a month. It's going to be a lot of work and a lot of changes.
What kind of changes, Curtis?
Well, I'm bringing a vocal arranger, and a choreographer, and Effie. Dina's going to sing lead.
Dina's doing what?
Lead.
What do you mean? I always sing lead.
We're changing, Effie.
We finally get the chance to have our own act, and Dina's doing lead? She can't sing like I can.
She's right, Curtis. I can't. I don't want to do it.
You do what I tell you. It's a new act, a new style, a new look.
New look? Nobody can see her on a record.
Well, that's going to be on records. Clubs, television. If you want to make it today, you got to make it on television.
So Dina's doing lead because you like the way she looks. Am I ugly to you, Curtis?
Of course not, Effie. You know how I feel about you. Don't make it personal.
What am I supposed to do? Dina's beautiful. She's always been beautiful. But I've got the voice, Curtis. I've got the voice. You can't put me in back. You just can't. I won't do it.
Hey! I've been waiting in that car for weeks. I've been waiting so long, Ray Charles had enough time to get himself another Grammy. Effie, what's the matter, baby?
You know Jimmy.
Well, I know. All I know is I want to see you unhappy.
Curtis wants to put me in back.
Effie, you gotta remember the best way to survive no matter where they put you.
Effie, you'll be singing backup with me. What's so wrong with it? Shoot, let Dina do all the work for a change.
We agreed that I would tell her.
The time came.
It shouldn't happen like this.
You knew about this, Cece?
Well, Curtis and I talked about it. He says it's only temporary. You see, we're gonna make the Dreams a real group sound, and your voice alone, it's too special. We need a lighter sound to cross over to the pop charts. It's what we need.
What about what I need?
Curtis says it's the best thing for the group.
What about what's best for me?
He feels that Dreams can cross over.
What about how I feel?
But when we're famous, I'll write great things for you. Effie, do it for me.
What about me? What about me?
It's more than you.
Showbiz, just a showbiz, showbiz.
Curtis. I did it.
I knew that you could.
Thank you.
job of yours.
Tear it apart, go ahead, and scream and shout.
1972 World Tour. Meet Dina Jones and the Incredible Dream.
Thank you.
my little girl started taking the stereo apart. She's so curious. I swear she's gonna be an engineer when she grows up.
Debbie White, this is Jerry Norman.
Hi, Jerry. Marty says you need a singer.
I was just telling Jerry here that you were real serious about working. He knows all about you.
You do, huh? Honey, you don't know the half. Why not after you hire me, we'll sit down and talk. Did you hear about the time in Philadelphia?
Okay, we don't want to take too much of his time. Carl knows some.
Carl? What happened to Bernard?
He had a job at Emmett.
Marty, you know I can't sleep with someone I don't know.
Effie, you got to.
I can't, you know that.
Effie, you gotta do this.
All right, Carl.
Jerry, please, just give me a minute. Last chance for you. Now, for the last 4 months, I've lent you money. I've taken you to every club in this freezing town. And I am telling you, this is it, Effie White. It's time that you stop making excuses so you don't have to prove anything. It's time that you get up and start proving yourself just like the rest of us do. You know what? Maybe Curtis was right about you. You want all the privileges, but none of the responsibilities. This is right after all. Thanks anyways. Sorry for wasting your time.
Marty, Curtis was wrong. Do you know this song?
Damn it, Marty, I told you I didn't want to see it.
Well, mister, you are. You are. Look at me. Look at me.
Thank you.
That song, One and Only, will be the beginning of a whole new style of music. And you're gonna make it popular for me. I'm booking you a tour to promote that song in every major city in the country.
I don't want a tour anymore.
What?
I don't want to sing anymore.
Just go up to talk. You don't just sing.
No, you don't understand. I want out of the dreams. You know, ever since Mama died, I realized I've been fooling myself. I promised her I'd be important.
Important? You're Dina Jones. Every woman in the country wants to be you.
No. Curtis, I want to be more. I want to be an artist. I want to act.
You're talking about that movie again.
Yes, it's a great part.
Sweetheart, I want you to do movies. I do. But it's the wrong property, Dina. The woman wasn't glamorous.
She was beautiful. She helped change the world.
It's wrong for you.
Maybe it's time I start deciding what is right and wrong for me. I love you, but I don't think you've ever seen me for what I really am.
When I first saw you, I said, oh my, oh my.
Thank you.
And the rest of you come in whenever I tell you to, all right?
Love Jimmy.
ever need any help, Jimmy, just give me a call.
Don't you worry, Curtis. Because I don't crawl. I'm an original, Curtis! I'm bad! I'm so bad! Cause I was here before you.
So No!
flight. Aren't you coming?
No! I want to stay and talk! I want to talk to the great Mission!
ladies and gentlemen of the press. I'm glad you make it here on such short notice. Now, you probably won't print this, but I would like to congratulate Miss Effie White. Recording, one and only, is the number one hit in the country. That's what I want to say. Now, to the rumors regarding me and my wife. Yes, we are separated. And the talk about her doing her first film is true. We're both very excited about that. Now here's something you don't know. The dreams are separated. Yes. Their final performance will be in New York, which is only fitting since that's where we all got started together. And oh, how impossible it seems that somehow I could destroy my dreams.
Ladies and gentlemen, in their farewell performance, they cry.
own special dream. And that dream's just about to come true.
Good night.